Hello students, welcome to Web Technologies online classes. Today onwards we are forwarding revision important classes. These videos will help you for your main semester examinations. Okay, now let us understand about the marks pattern and paper pattern for this subject once again. Okay, already in the previous classes whenever we have started the introduction part of this subject, so in that class also I have discussed it, but again one more time I would like to explain for your understanding purpose. So now let us understand about the course pattern. Okay, here the paper, actually examination duration of this web technologies paper 1.5 hours only, remaining all subjects 2 hours duration, because of during this pandemic they have reduced the time for the examinations. 3 hours examination they have reduced with 2 hours examination, two hours duration. But from the starting onwards our computer subjects having the 1.5 hour duration, so that's why they haven't changed anything in the time duration. Okay, so directly for the computer subject we can use the 1.5 hour exam only. 1.5 hour duration, the time duration is only 1.5 hour for the web technology subject, similar to FIT, programming with C and C++, or DBMS. So similar like web technology subject also examination duration is only 1.5 hour. Okay, here 50 marks theory paper, 35 marks practical, 15 marks for internal, total 100 marks for this subject. So for the theory examination purpose only 50 marks paper, so that's why the time has only 1.5 hour. 35 marks for practical, 15 marks for internal examinations. So now let us understand about the paper pattern. So carefully observe here. Yes, and this is the paper pattern. This is the paper pattern. So for the web technology subject there are two parts, part A and part B. In the part A they will give short answer questions, they will give 8 short answer questions. In that 8 questions you have to write any 5 out of 8 questions, you have to write any 5. Remaining 3 are your choice. Okay, so each question carries 2 marks, so total 5 questions you have to write in the short answer, so 5 2s are 10 marks. This is the part A section. And in the part B section they will give 10 questions, out of 10 questions you have to write any 5 questions. So actually how they will give these 10 questions, according to Osmania University syllabus we have 5 unit syllabus. We have 5 units of syllabus, am I correct or not? So from the 5 units they will give 10 questions. So each unit we will get 2 questions. For the first unit these 2 questions, for the second unit these 2 questions, for the third unit these 2 questions, for the fourth unit 7-8 questions, for the fifth unit 9-10 questions. So in that out of 10 questions you have to write any 5 questions. So each question carry 8 marks, total 40 marks. So the paper, total paper contain 40 plus 10, 50 marks is the theory paper marks. So this is the paper pattern for the web technologies subject. Actually this paper pattern we have followed already in the FIT, in the RDBMS, in programming with C and C++, we have already followed. And for the web technology subject also we have to follow this paper pattern. Okay, right. And this video continuation onwards you will get important video lectures class, and you have to listen carefully, then you can understand about the important points. If you have any doubts then ask me directly through mobile phone call. Okay, through mobile, then I will give the I will give the clarity further for your doubts. Thank you very much, and enjoy the revision classes. Hello students, welcome to Web Technologies online classes. Today I am going to explain about the concept of the basic structure of HTML program. Today concept is the basic structure of HTML program. Now let us start our session. Okay, right. Explain the basic structure of HTML. Basic structure of HTML document is nothing but there are different types of sections. Actually, first we have to see browser. For that, I am opening Chrome browser here. Then only you can understand what is the structure we have. This is the browser window. After double clicking on that, automatically the screen will appear like this. This is Chrome browser window, and this is title bar. Here new tab is there, na? This is title bar because of here showing the title. By default, the Chrome it will show the new tab. This is the title. If you want to open one more tab, then here plus symbol is there, na? You just click on that. Automatically it will open new window. But in this browser, now we haven't opened anything, na? Any website. So that's why it is showing an empty browser. That's why it is showing an empty browser along with Google search bar. But by default it is showing in the title bar as a new tab. And this is address bar. If you want to open any website, a URL you need to type in this box. Then after typing is over, then immediately press enter key. Then the browser will search for that website. Next, these are the bookmarks. These are the bookmarks toolbar. For example, if you regularly open any website, daily you are opening one website. So daily you are typing a URL and pressing enter key is the burden because every day we are opening same thing, na? So just by clicking on only one option, then immediately it will open that website. For that, bookmarks are very useful. So how the bookmark will add here? For example, here I am opening Usmania University window, usmania.ac.in. This is our university website. Because of it is showing no internet option, but the URL is correct. Because of in my laptop I don't have any internet connection here. So that's why it is showing no internet, but the website URL is correct. But daily I am opening this website, but every time this website URL I need to type in the search bar, na? So after that I need to press one enter key also, then only the browser will search for this website. So every time this process is, I am feeling very burdened. So that's why I am adding a bookmark. Once I open this website, Here star mark is there, na? So you click on that star mark. Add bookmark option is came, na? So click on that also. Automatically it will open one window, one pop-up window. So it is asking, am I add this website as a bookmark? Okay, done. Then immediately it will add. Where it is showing after adding that one? Open new tab. Here it is showing www.usmania.ac.in, that website is showing. Just you click on that, automatically it will open that website. If you have internet connection, directly the request will go to Usmania University website, and after that the response will come from the server. The browser will take that response, and that complete website content of the page it will display here. So that is the use of bookmarks. So bookmarks toolbar is also very useful for this. So now you have understood about the browsers. This is title bar. This is address bar. So this complete entire from here to here, from here to from here is header section. Is called header section. And after that, from here to here, from here to here, the complete white space is there now along with Google search engine. So this complete part is called body section. This complete part is called body section. So just you remember this one. After explanation completion of about the basic structure of HTML, then you will get an awareness about on this web page, how it can divide in two types. So what is the first part and what is the second part, you can understand everything after explanation is over. So now I am starting about the HTML program, HTML page structure, basic structure of HTML. For that I am minimizing this window and I am opening this one. So HTML, every HTML document or page has a basic structure. Every HTML document or page has a basic structure. Mainly we have 5 basic elements to develop any HTML document. Develop any HTML document. They are, first one is doc type HTML tag. Doc type HTML tag. And second one is HTML tag. Third one is head tag. Fourth one is title tag. Fifth one is body tag. So if you want to write any HTML program, if you want to develop any front end page for any website, compulsory these 5 elements are mandatory to use. Mandatory, these 5 elements are mandatory. And HTML opening tag and closing tag, these 2 are optional. Because of if you save with .html extension in your web file, I mean, if for example if you want to write one program that is related to web program, nothing but internal it can use HTML concepts, HTML tags. So after that you need to save that file na. So that file if you save with .html extension, automatically browser can understand this is completely our execution program, I mean our related program, so we need to execute that one. So this HTML opening tag and closing tag must and should be required, but these 2 are optional here. But if you want to add, then it is no problem. But if you haven't added, web server it can understand, I mean web browser internally it is maintaining one interpreter. That interpreter it can understand it is HTML related program, so no need to write this one. HTML tags are optional. HTML opening tag and closing tag are optional. But remaining all tags are mandatory to use. If you want to display any title for your web page, then title tag is also mandatory. Because of in between these title tags, the web page name we need to configure that name. So then only the browser, here new tab is displaying na. If you write these 2 tags in any name, in between these 2 tags, if you write any name, it will display that name here only. It will display that name here only. Don't worry, I will explain with practically also. Just you can understand this one. So these 5 tags are very important. These 5 tags are very important. Doc type HTML, first option we have to see right now. Doc type HTML, at starting time, at starting point, we need to use exclamatory mark. Doc type exclamatory mark. So in the keyboard, it is from top to down, it is a second row. It is available in the second row in the keyboard. At 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0, that numbers are there na. In that 1 and exclamatory marks, these 2 keys are available in that button. If you want to use this one, shift and that one button it you need to press, then the second symbol it will present on the screen. Exclamatory mark is very useful for the doc type. Why doc type here? For the HTML program, doc type is nothing but it is indicating the version. All HTML documents must start with doc type declaration. All HTML document must start with a doc type declaration. Without doc type declaration, If you use HTML4, HTML3, HTML2, that syntax is, it cannot be understand. It cannot be understand. So if you use doc type HTML, if you use this one, this is the value here actually. HTML5 syntax this one. If you use doc type space HTML, then we are intimating to our browser. These all tags are related to HTML5 syntax based. HTML5 syntax based. So that is indicating HTML version. And HTML4, HTML3, HTML2, that configuration is different. That configuration is different. HTML doc type tag is used to inform the browser about the version of HTML used in the document. It is called as a document type declaration. Because of it is a DTD. In the short form, we can call the DTD. Every HTML program, every web page internally contain doc type declaration. The doc type declaration is nothing but document type declaration. We need to give the information for the browser, and this complete syntaxes are used under the HTML5. If you use simply HTML, lowercase, if you use simple HTML aligned with doc type, and this complete type, this complete web page belongs to HTML5 version. All of you carefully observe, and remaining tags, all remaining doc types also we have. For that I am connecting my phone to my laptop, and that is different to this one. So all of you carefully observe. Now I am connecting my phone to laptop. Okay, it is connected. For that, here previously I shown this bookmark. Now just I am clicking this one. All of you carefully observe. Now the internet connection is available to my laptop. Then this bookmark will work properly. I am clicking on that one. So automatically that website has opened. So that is the use of bookmark. So leave this one. Again I am opening Chrome browser. Doc type declaration for doc type. Declaration for HTML4, for the HTML4 version I am searching. So if you want to develop any HTML4th version project, if you want to develop any project under the HTML4 by using HTML4, that doc type declarations are different. All of you carefully observe. This is HTML5 version. Because of simply they can reduce it. Simply they have reduced this one. Compared to this one, HTML4 is very critical to write the DTD. Doc type HTML, public. So this entire lens, older HTML documents, nothing but HTML4 or XHTML. HTML4 is the old, compared to HTML5, HTML4 is the older version. So that's why this is the doc type declaration. So first of all, we need to see, we have to see the simple HTML document. Simple HTML document. All of you carefully observe. The first program. Simple HTML program, sorry, not a document. Okay, all of you carefully observe. This is program na. Starting line is what? Angular bracket open and exclamatory mark, doc type space HTML. Because of this is HTML5 version. Simply they used HTML. Because of after using many versions, and doc type declaration is also has reduced by the web developers. So that's why simply they given HTML for the latest version. Now the latest version is what in the HTML? HTML5. Actually HTML1, HTML2, HTML3, HTML4, HTML5, like that 5 versions we have. So each and every older version, HTML1, HTML2, HTML3, HTML4, all 4 versions are doc type declaration is very critical. But in the HTML5, it is very simple. You can simply write lowercase HTML word, then it can understand, the browser can understand. The project is completely belongs to HTML5. HTML5 based. And HTML4 syntaxes you have to see right here. You can see doc type html public this complete line you have to write on that project if you use the html4 xhtml also like this so like that it is if you use this one the doc type declaration is very critical to write na so this much code you have to write but if you use html5 it is very simple a simple word is enough html lower case along with doc type understand so that is the doc type declaration actually what purpose it can use doc type declaration is nothing but it is intimating to browser which version this project has containing which version syntaxes which version base it has developed so that information need to give the browser then only that syntaxes will allow by the browser while executing time understand while executing time that browser can understand that version and if it is a html5 simply they can allow if it is html4 that is also can allow but intimating of the version is one version to another version some enhancements also there na so html4 contains some limitations so to overcome that limitation html5 has introduced it because of that is the fresh version so all problems has avoided by the html5 na so we need to use html5 so but previous versions also maintaining by the browsers because of some projects are done by the html4 and some projects are migrated to html5 but till now some html4 projects also going on na so sometimes html4 dtd is also very useful so that's why they are not deleted that one so previous versions also the web standards company is maintaining the previous versions also so that's why we need to learn that one we need to learn this one also html older versions also we have to know and present current version also we have to learn and compared to older version present current versions advanced versions are very easy because of their problems avoided by the new versions so that's why fresh versions I mean latest versions are very useful to understand and to develop the programs later fresh versions are very useful so compared to html4 html5 is very easy to write doc type declaration actually doc type declaration is used to intimate the version information for the browser window so now you have understood about the doc type declaration doc type is nothing but dtd is nothing but document type declaration in the short form we can simply call like this dtd next html this is the root element this tag is used to initiate the html program and by using html opening tag we can able to create web document and web pages it has opening and closing tag because of it is a parent tag open tag and also closing tag simply we can use the slash symbol if you want to close that same html tag and one is the opening tag one is the closing tag there is no difference between this and that one but a simple only one difference what is that here extra we need to use one slash symbol if you want to use any parent tags same thing it happened opening tag and closing tag both names are same but closing tag contain extra one character nothing but a slash character it has opening and closing tag in between opening and closing tag mainly we should maintain two sections they are header section and body section header section and body section all of you carefully observe here a simple program is there na here head part is optional but body part is mandatory because of some text content or some web content we need to represent on the screen all of you carefully observe here title tag used na html editors so that concept is going on in that concept is representing on the screen this website W3 school website now I am opening html editors option so that's why that related name it is representing on the screen in the title bar but in the blank sheet it is showing new tab na but if it is a the project contain html title tag na it has configured with the title tag configured with html editors so that's why it is printing the name of the page this entire page name is editors option page name is html editors There are two parts in the web page. First one is header section and second one is body section. All of you carefully observe. This is a simple program. This is the structure of HTML document diagram, and the doc type declaration is mandatory for each and every program. But while learning them, sometimes if you haven't read that one, no problem. If you haven't read that one, no problem, because of it is a learning stage. But while developing at real time, compulsory doc type declaration is mandatory for real time projects. So that's why from now onwards you need to you don't want to forget this one also. Compulsory you need to use, you have to use that one in your developing time. And HTML is the root tag, opening tag and closing tag. So these, between these two tags, we have to configure head section and body section. Head section contain title information, nothing but a web page title page title we have to configure, and also some extra content links we have to configure. But for your understanding purpose, I given title tag only here, and remaining tags it will come while the concept is going on time, and remaining tags I will explain. But those tags also we need to configure in the head section. But head section contains some less tags. Head section contain some less tags, but body section contains number of presenting tags, number of presentational tags. Understand? Because of that is the main part to represent on the screen. Whatever the website information want to show on the screen, compulsory in the body part we have to configure with the different tags. Our text content is configured with different tags, so that's why body part is very important. So now understand this diagram. This is the root tag, HTML opening tag and HTML closing tag. In that two sections, header section and body section. Header section contain what? Title tag. Head part, nothing but this head part information is available in this header part. And next one, body part contain whatever the text content we have to represent on this, we need to represent on the screen, that text contents information available in the body section. Because of that, body part is exhibit our information to users. Now understand, nah? But now we have to see a simple program. Now we have to see a simple program for your understanding purpose. For that, I am opening on Notepad. Here, search option is there, na? In that Notepad, you have to type. Notepad is came, na? In my system, Windows operating system is running, so that's why in the search bar, in the search box, I have typed Notepad. Then it is representing whatever the icon I am searching. Searching icon it is representing. But if you use Windows 7, go to Start button. Here, Programs option is there. After that, Accessories. Accessories, in that Accessories, Notepad option we have. You can click on that. But in my Windows operating system, Notepad I am opening like this. Okay. So font is also increasing for your understanding. Okay, already 28 font is available, so no problem. In your system, if you want to increase this font, then same, go to format menu, choose font option. In that, font style, font model and size is also available. So based on your requirement, you need to select all those things and click on OK button. Now the doc type declaration, doc type declaration, HTML I am using, because of I am using HTML5 version. HTML is the root tag and opening and closing tag. HTML is in case sensitive. HTML is in case sensitive because of, if you want to use a lower case letters or upper case letters, there is no problem, browser can understand. But better to recommend lower case letters. Better to recommend lower case letters. According to industry standards, you better to use lower case letters. Because of, after that CSS, cascading style sheets, in the next unit it will come. And after that JavaScript option is also there. JavaScript is nothing but, it is also one of the programming language, scripting language. So compulsory, some lower case characters we need to use, because of JavaScript is a case sensitive programming language. So that's why from here onwards, we need to use lower case letters. But the HTML purpose, either lower case letters or upper case letters, both are same. But while using JavaScript, compulsory we need to use lower case letters because of it is programming language. It contains programming language syntaxes. So that's why. Static language is HTML is nothing but static language, but JavaScript is nothing but dynamic programming language. So HTML, static programming language contains either you can use lower case letters or upper case letters. It's your wish. But coming to JavaScript, compulsory we need to use that related syntaxes. Nothing but lower case letters are recommended because of all syntaxes comes under in the lower case letter. Because of JavaScript is in case sensitive. Sorry, JavaScript is case sensitive. HTML is in case sensitive. So that's why in the HTML uppercase letters, lowercase letters both are same. But in the JavaScript uppercase letters and lowercase letters both are not same. Both are different. So that's why from here onwards we need to use lowercase letters in the HTML. So now the root element is HTML opening tag and HTML closing tag. After that, again two sections, head open and also head close. Head close. Again, body part I am opening, body tag I am closing, body tag I am closing. So all of you carefully observe. This is a simple program for your understanding purpose I am writing. And next, title tag I am configuring here. Title opening and title close. So here, welcome page I am typing. My title name is, my web page title is welcome page. Okay. Next, body page. Here, now I am saving this one. Here I am not writing anything here. Just for your understanding purpose, head part I configured, body tags I use it. But in between body tags, I haven't configured anything, any data. So now I am saving. How to save this one? Go to file menu, choose save option. And this is my web page, na? My web page dot HTML. My web page, this name is your wish. Up to here, here I given my web page, na? It is my page name, my website page name. But dot HTML is mandatory for each and every HTML file. And this name is your wish. And next, save as type is all files you need to select. Click on save button. Because of this file is location is available on the desktop. Now I am saving on the desktop. All of you carefully observe. So my web page option is file has saved on the desktop na. So if you want to execute this file, if you saved correctly, then the browser window, your file will appear along with browser icon. If you save correctly, your file will appear on the screen like this with the browser icon. So if you want to execute this one, double click on that. Automatically it open in the browser window. So all of you carefully observe. And welcome page is indicating where. Welcome page is showing where. Here. Because of this is the title of the web page. So in this place it is displaying. For that purpose, I have configured in the head section, in between title tags, I have configured like this. So if I want to represent any text content in compulsory, I need to write in the body section. Like body section is nothing but from here to here, I need to type. So this complete white space is called to body section. So here I am using heading 1 opening tag, opening closing tag, sorry, here welcome to India. Now I am saving again. I have typed some extra content na. Again I want to save na. Go to file menu, choose save option. If you change anything, if you change anything in your document, compulsory you need to save again also. And this page is already open na. Now I am refreshing this page. So it is indicating na. I mean the text is showing like this. And now I want to show this line in middle of the web page. For that, you just remember this one. Next, in the next class, I will explain about the attributes concept. Then you can understand simply. But for the H1, the text content want to display in the middle of the page. But this is which one? H1 tag, na? Heading tag, that one. So that heading tag, opening tag, I have configured like this. I need to configure like this. Align equal to center, in between double quotes, the value has configured here. And again go to file menu, choose save option. Now I am refreshing this page. All of you carefully observe, the text has aligned, I mean the heading has aligned in the center of the page at top position. So now understand na? HTML is the root tag, head is the first section, body is the second section. HTML page, this complete HTML page has divided into two sections. First one is head tag and second one is body tag. Head tag contains title of the page. Body tag contains some text content. Here I am representing this one. Now observe na. Now you have to see the diagram. Then only you can understand. If you want to see this complete source code, this page source code, just right click. Control U is the source code option. If you want to see this complete web page source code, then Control U is the option. Then immediately one more window it will open. It will show the code like this. Same code I have configured na. Carefully observe. So same code it is showing na. This is the first program. Now you all of you have an awareness on this. What is the structure of basic structure of HTML program? What are the elements we have used? And the web page contain how many sections? Header section, body section. But each and every web page contain doc type declaration. If you use doc type declaration, the browser can understand which version this complete page comes under, which version, and which version syntaxes they have used, that can support. Support by the browser. So that's why we need to give the doc type declaration. And doc type declaration is also called document type declaration. In the short form we need to call DTD, document type declaration. HTML is the root element, opening tag and closing tag. In between these two tags we have to write our page content. So actually that HTML page, complete HTML has divided into two sections. One is the header section and second one is the body section. Header section contain web page title information and extra information, but it is not visible. The code is not visible. Only title of the page, except title of the page, remaining all those things hide in position. Hide position. Except title of the page and remaining code, it is in hide position. But in the body section comes everything, it will present on the screen without tags. So opening tag and closing tag, angular brackets if you use, and it is called markup language. Hypertext is nothing but a text within the text. Actually this is also one of the text and this is also one of the text, but in between these text, one more text we have configured na. This type of configuration is called hypertext. And what is markup language? Angular brackets we can use na for the element. H1 is one element. So if you use the H1 element along with angular brackets, that is also opening tag and closing tag, So we are intimating to the browser now. So these tags are has predefined functionality. So that's why you need to understand. For you, this is completely related to your browser related tags. So you feel this one. If you while executing time, these all are based on these rules. Based on these rules, you can execute that execute this this text content. So here rules are what? H1 is one element for the heading purpose. So that H1 tag contains predefined functionality, na built-in functionality. So that functionality can understand by which what browser, because of browser can execute only hypertext markup languages. Am I correct or not? So hypertext syntaxes are integrated with HTML tags only. So that's why it is called markup language. Markup tags or markup syntaxes are nothing but HTML tags. Understand? Now you already know. Now I have explained how to write the first program in web pages. I mean in the HTML. So that is also you can understand. If you have any doubt, then ask me by phone call. Because of you don't have any live classes, that's why. If you have any doubts, first you search in the Google. If you haven't get any clarity, then ask me directly by using phone. I will give the complete awareness on this. So structure of HTML page is completed. And while writing, while your exam is going time, if they will give this question, then this diagram is also very important to write. So compulsory to draw this diagram while in the examination's time. Next one. In the next class, I will explain about the what is web design. List and explain web design principles. What is web design? And list and explain with web design principles. Now I am stopping this session. Thank you. Thank you very much.